Music. It's the love of music that brings us together. The love of music that forms the bond between us. For the next hour, join us for the love of music, presenting those aspects of music which excite, provoke, and inspire. Our host today is David Dubal, WNCN music director, pianist, educator, and writer on music. Here is David Dubal for the love of music.
On this program, my guest, Ruth Schonthal, and she is one of the foremost composers, man, woman, or child, in the whole New York area. You're one of the busiest musicians, Ruth, practicing this glorious art. How are you today?
I'm very well.
Do you know what we're going to do today?
Yes, I feel very fortunate that you're going to perform some of my works.
Not me personally, but through the amazing electronic world, we are going to have other performers who have put on tape your works, three works, and we'll hear more music than usual on this program because you're such a cyclic composer, really, that to cut your works is very, very difficult, so we have found out. We'll be hearing on this program what? First, your song cycle, By the Roadside, mm-hmm. correct?
Yes.
Words
yes.
by whom?
Walt Whitman.
Oh, he's famous.
Yes.
And what else?
And String Quartet, which goes into very small movements that interconnect. One thought leads to the next.
Aha, and that's why we could not cut it. It's about 11 mm-hmm. movements, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a fine pianist, Alec Chien. Is that pronounced right?
That's right, Alec Chien.
Doing your set of preludes mm-hmm. in homage of.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll discuss that later. But first I want to say that you're on the faculty of New York University, that you teach quite a bit, that you're constantly active wherever one goes. Ruth is there. I don't know how you do it. You're a performer on the piano of real attainment. You have won, what, first prize in a competition once?
Yes, yes, and in Mexico.
In Mexico, third
yes.
prize in another.
Yes.
You've studied with famous
yes.
teachers, Madame Simone Barrer and Gordon
mm-hmm.
Nitsky.
Mm-hmm.
You've studied orchestration with Creston, who knows the orchestra well. And I would like to ask what it meant to you to study with Paul Hindemith, who taught here in America.
Well, I was in Mexico when I met Paul Hindemith, and I showed him some of my compositions because I was very eager to study with him, and he arranged for a scholarship for me at Yale, where I studied composition with him.
Mm.
But this was after I had already written a great deal, including a piano concerto. When he first saw my music, he said, well, actually, all that's needed is to change your bass lines. That could be more interesting. I don't think we need anything else. After I had studied with him for a while, so we discovered, since this was a class instruction, that I just simply had to go along with everything that everybody else was doing as well. And we discussed this briefly, whether this would be a problem. I said, well, either one is strong enough, one bends or one breaks, and I have a feeling I will not break. So he laughed. I said, I don't think you will.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know there are many people who, you know, feel that Hindemith is a very difficult person, and many people rebelled against his teachings, and I can understand it.
Mm-hmm.
I can understand it. I'm sympathetic to it. I think I would not like him as my first teacher.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, serious teacher,
mm-hmm.
you see. I think one had to pick and choose afterwards. Many people feel Hindemith students all sound alike, and that there's a reason for it, of course, because he was so methodical that he analyzed everything, and that included aesthetic. And once you do that, then, of course, if you say and make criteria, what is a good melody, what makes a good harmony, what makes a good progression, how to compose, then, of course, the result will be the same.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
This is exactly what your work is not, Ruth Schonthal. It
no.
is never the same. Each work seems to dictate the idiom almost.
I think you hit it absolutely the nail on the head here. That is really my credo. I let what I want to do dictate how I treat it.
Mm-hmm.
And from one song cycle, a different poet, a different style will totally change my music because I adjust that to the mood and message.
And we'll really hear this in these three works, which are very different. Describe the process that you went through and how you came to these poems for this song cycle, By the Roadside, which is the first work we'll hear today.
Yes, well, you see from my biography that I have a rather extensive German background. And in much of my music, that is felt. But I wanted to do something very American. Uh-huh. In other words, it was a real desire to be American, and whom could I choose more than Walt Whitman? And I really admired these poems. Mm-hmm. Now, the poems that I chose are very short and very concentrated. So these songs reflect that. They're almost one page or two page long, mm-hmm. and come to a climax very fast, mm-hmm. zero in and zero out.
So we'll hear the whole song cycle, which takes only 6 minutes and 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. And in this performance, you yourself, the composer, Ruth Schonthal at the piano, and Bernice Bramson is the soprano. Am I right?
That's correct.
Here we go.
Thank you.
I applaud that too, Ruth Schonthal. Mm-hmm. That was your song cycle by the roadside, Walt Whitman poetry. We heard Bernice Bramson singing, and you at the piano, and quite a pianist you are. And after this message, will you return to talk with me again?
Yes, with great pleasure.
Okay. My guest is the composer, an American composer born in Hamburg, Ruth Schonthal, and we heard her by the roadside, and we were discussing the fact that each work dictates its own idiom for you. The string quartet was 1962, but we'll be hearing that last. We'll be hearing a set of preludes for piano, and describe them, because it's interesting. You have in homage of, and then
nothing.
Dots. Yes.
That's right. Of course, mostly they're in homage of Chopin. I have always admired Chopin's preludes as one of the greatest pieces of music because he concentrates so much on one page or a few.
Yes.
In less than a minute. And this kind of an ideal of the unnecessary notes and concentration has always fascinated me. So they are dedicated mostly to Chopin, but also to romantic piano music in general and other composers whom I admire. There's some Rachmaninoff, there's Scriabin, there's Hindemith, and there's Bartok as well, and whatever you want to hear.
I can't wait to hear these. There are 24 in number. That seems to be the accepted package. Are they also in every key, like the...
They're in many, many diverse keys.
And
they're
so
very contrasting to each other.
They're 18 minutes in length now, so in a way you've outdone Chopin.
That's right. Some really come, they're supposed to sort of appear and disappear like a comet, some of them. But later on, something that went too fast, later on sort of is reborn in another shape, so there is a consistency.
Again, that's why you can't just simply break your pieces up. You have this unified quality that you're always thinking ahead. Now, you have a performer here, Alec Chien.
Yes.
And he has played the set. Are these of great difficulty, like the Chopin preludes?
They're just about even to the Chopin preludes. There are some that could be played by students.
But many that demand virtuosity.
It's a concert piece, yes.
Now, I know that Oxford University Press is doing some of your works, publishing them. And I hope that these are published because pianists need a new set of preludes.
Well, you know, it takes time and money. And patience.
Well, then a publisher should hear this and get on the ball because we need music published too. It seems to be an aspect of thinking which nobody partakes in. How does music get published? And is music published? It's taken for granted because we hear it orally all the time. But it has to be able to be bought.
Well, this is a very big problem, and we are in a state of transition. Xerox has done a lot of harm, so that publishers have really suffered financially, and they have to think many times before they can take on a new work. The printing costs have spiraled and so on.
So difficult. We'll now hear Ruth Schonthal's 24 preludes and the pianist Alec Chien. Thank you.
Thank you.
24 preludes entitled In Homage Of by my guest, the American composer Ruth Schonthal. And after this message, we'll be back talking with my guest, Ruth Schonthal, and we'll be hearing her string quartet. This is David Dubal, and I am back. Ruth Schonthal has had her works performed not only now on WNCN, but in Belgrade, in London, in Mexico City, in Paris, and elsewhere. And there's no doubt your career is moving along. There'll be two important recordings in 81, and that is a song cycle of yours, which is produced on Leonarda Productions. What is that?
This is entitled Totengesänge. It's a long cycle, 26 minutes long, with my own words in German.
Oh, in your own words. Mm-hmm. And this is a rather searing, moving major work of over 20 minutes, isn't it?
Yes, it's a serious work, but it gets rather sardonic and funny towards the end.
Well, there were many little comic touches here and there. The word comic is not perhaps correct, but in the preludes there were allusions and subconscious aspects going on all of the time. You also have a very different piano work coming out on a new label called Capriccio.
Yes.
Gary Steigerwalt is playing a work of yours. What's the name of that work?
No, that is a total record of piano compositions of mine.
All yours, wonderful.
They're all different ones, yes.
So this is something you're going to look forward to very much, I'm sure, and so will we. So there's two recordings, and is there some possibility of an opera that you're doing?
Yes, I finished a full-length one-act opera using an original play by A.A. Milne. It's called The Courtship of Camilla. His play is called The Ugly Duckling.
Uh-huh. Now, obviously, from this discussion, I get the idea that you do not compose for any one specific branch of the art. You like to do every possible combination. We'll hear a string quartet. We have piano works and opera. Have you worked in the realm of orchestra?
Oh, yes. Yes, I have things for orchestra, and I have two piano concertos, as a matter of fact.
Have you performed any of your piano concertos?
Yes, I have performed my first one when I was 18 years old. It's lying in a trunk now. I don't like it.
It's too romantic. Too romantic. Too derivative, perhaps, right?
I don't know. It's just...
There can be not any music that's too romantic. I think all great music is romantic. Yeah. But I know exactly what you're saying. Now, you have studied in Mexico City under another important composer, which we don't really know much about here, and that's Manuel Ponce.
Yes.
What did he give you? Because you studied with Hindemith, a very different composer.
Yes. Well, Ponce was much too permissive, I must say. Mm-hmm. He really didn't want to criticize anything that I was doing. Mm-hmm. And that is not good for a student.
Now, to say the least, born in Hamburg, Ruth Schonthal was the youngest pupil to enter the famous Stern Conservatory in Berlin. What did that mean to you when, at 5 years old, entering a conservatory? Did you know then music was it?
Music? I started composing when I was five.
You're a prodigy.
And I started improvising right away. And so that's with my composition I was accepted. And I was given a rather rigorous and wonderful beginning. Piano twice a week, theory a whole morning, and in addition to that, very soon, a teacher where I was permitted to sit in when he was analyzing Beethoven sonatas and later operas, and I was allowed to turn the page. It was great.
Then later, at 13, you went to Stockholm. You were the youngest ever to enter the Royal Academy in Stockholm.
That's right. So that was difficult.
That was, how do you mean?
Because I had to learn Swedish, yes. I had to do it in Swedish.
Wow.
Yes.
So you've been a very busy woman your whole life, really.
Yes, always.
And yet you don't call it toil, that's for sure. You love music with a radiance. I mean, when you hear music, any music I have noticed, a Beethoven sonata or a Scriabin etude, there's a light and a gleam that enters your being.
Yes, music permeates my life, that is true.
Now, the pianist in you has become sublimated to the composer totally around this time in your career, right?
Yes. Last year, I had to finally make the decision, much mm-hmm. as it hurt, that it just wasn't possible. Writing a big thing like the opera next to all the teaching activities, I just had to let something go, and it was the piano.
Yeah, I well understand this time element. And the time element now is upon us that we have to stop this conversation for a moment, and we will be back, and we'll then hear your string quartet. And I want to hear about this improvisation, which nobody mm-hmm. seems to do much anymore, mm-hmm. and you are really a master of it. Ruth Schonthal is my guest, and we'll be right back. And we continue our program. Ruth Schonthal, who has been my guest today, we have heard her song cycle by the roadside and her piano preludes. What about the string quartet? And, oh, before we do that, let's, that subject, improvisation. This was a great part until about 1830, musical life. Everyone had to do it, but pianists or violinists don't improvise anymore, right?
Some do. It is becoming the thing to do, but I prefer composers who improvise from instrumentalists. You see, instrumentalists have facility, and that is very good. Composers have to do a little bit more with it.
All right. Very quickly, because of the time element, we don't want to break your quartet. It will be 14 minutes in length. Tell us when, how, why you did this work, and what you meant by it, and so forth.
I composed it in a time which was a good time for me, musically speaking. I wrote a great deal of music that I still like, and the string quartet is one of them. And I love to write contrapuntally, and I love to write for strings, and that's really why I wrote it.
We're going to hear it in a performance by the York String Quartet, Ruth Schonthal's only string quartet?
Yes. Yes, it's my only one.
And here we have it.
Thank you.
String Quartet by Ruth Schonthal, a clever and moving work, especially moving. Ruth, we have very little time, no words at all except for me to say thanks for coming, and we will be here again next season when those new recordings come out, because your works are very important.
Thank you, Mr. Dubal. I enjoyed being here.
This is David Dubal, and thank you for listening.
For the Love of Music, with today's host, David Dubal, WNCN Music Director. We hope you'll be with us when once again we meet to listen and exchange ideas, all for the love of music. For the Love of Music is produced by WNCN New York, GAF Broadcasting Company.